Ladies and gentlemen, we are only 24 hours removed from Femme Fatale. And ladies and gentlemen, what an event it was. Of course, the main event of the evening, the talk of the entire CAW world, the 60-minute Iron Vixen match between the champion Aerith Gainsborough and the number one contender Tiffa Lockhart. And ladies and gentlemen, it did not disappoint. 60 minutes of CAW wrestling excellence. Easily one of the best matches in the history of the entire sport. Both women threw caution to the wind. Both women held nothing back, never took a back step, took it to one another for 60 straight minutes. It was brutal, it was intense, it was grueling. And perhaps these two women will never be the same. Of course, ladies and gentlemen, throughout the entire night, we had crowned a new VWF Hardcore Champion in Lara Croft, new Tag Team Champions in Haruka and Michiru, and ladies and gentlemen, Aerith Gainsborough was trying to be the only competitor last night to retain her title. But there you see one of the moves to help turn the tide. A death-defying leap from the ladder through a table. Aerith at one point went down 2-0, but rallied back to tie it. Went down once again and tied it again. And then finally, with 11 minutes to go, of course, hit the great gospel and took her first lead after 50 minutes. Then it was all tied up again. We entered into the final stretch wondering if we would see a draw for a clear-cut winner. And then, with half a minute to spare, the champion, Aerith Gainsborough, showed why she is the fighting champion she is. Catch a twist of fate, and she put away Tiffa with 20 seconds to spare. Tiffa had no time left to knot it up. And Aerith Gainsborough retained the Vixens Wrestling Federation title. And just as we all thought we were about to close out on a very Merry Christmas, the Queen of the Mountain, Usagi Tsukino, came out and shocked the entire CAW wrestling world. You're seeing the footage right here. Aerith, of course, thanking the fans for supporting her during her long absence. But then, it was Usagi Tsukino cashing in her Queen of the Mountain contract. Ladies and gentlemen, I still can't believe it. The sold-out crowd of 20,000 plus, I'm sure, still in shock. And of course, after 60 minutes, Aerith could do nothing. She could not even intelligently defend herself. And just like that, Usagi sneaks up like a thief in the night, ever the opportunist, and she becomes a new Vixens Wrestling Federation champion. And now, ladies and gentlemen, that led us right to where we are, back here in the VWF arena, the scene of the crime. And there you see the new Vixens Wrestling Federation champion, Usagi Tsukino. What does she have in store for us here tonight on Nitro? Well, wait a minute. Usagi and Ray here. All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the sold-out VWF Arena. And ladies and gentlemen, what an opening contest we've got scheduled for you, our first match since Femme Fatale. Of course, we have three brand new Vixens Wrestling Federation champions. We have a new hardcore champion, the Tomb Raider Lara Croft. We have new tag team champions, the Outer Senshi, Haruka and Michiru. And, of course, we have a new Vixens Wrestling Federation champion, Usagi Tsukino, who is once again Sailor Moon, the leader of the Sailor Senshi. Of course, if this had been a week ago, I perhaps would have been very jubilant that Usagi Tsukino had earned her way back into the Senshi. But of course, last night, she showed her true colors, cashing in her Queen of the Mountain briefcase after Aerith Gainsborough had gone through a grueling, career-shortening 60-minute Iron Vixen match. And of course, it was academic. And ladies and gentlemen, after a long talk with VWF management, I must apologize for my behavior last night at Femme Fatale after Usagi won the title. I have to go on record as officially apologizing. It is my job to stay neutral, of course, ladies and gentlemen, but off the record, it was tough to stay neutral. Just a contemptible act. And, of course, Usagi Tsukino now showing the true colors that she had had hidden within all along. You already saw her going on the air tonight, bossing around fellow Senshi member and her opponent last night that she defeated in an Inferno match, Rei Hino. So already, quote-unquote, Queen Usagi showing her true colors. And, of course, we have Yuna already in the ring, and here comes Jill Valentine, former commissioner of New Gen Wrestling, a former NGW Women's Champion, winner of the second annual Rose Night Diva Invitational last year. She has done it all here in CAW. A former member of DCW Digital Championship Wrestling, owned by Triple R, one of my good friends, who I would like to send my well wishes to. Ladies and gentlemen, we here at the Vixens Wrestling Federation hope you had a very Merry Christmas and a very happy holiday. We hope you got to spend it with your loved ones, your family and friends, and we just hope that you felt the spirit of the season. But now, it's time to get back down to business. Our first Nitro removed from Femme Fatale. You talk about an event that was marred with controversy, the talk of the CAW wrestling world. A lot to talk about regarding Femme Fatale. And tonight, you just have to wonder if we will see any immediate repercussions from what occurred last night. Of course, Lara Croft, your new hardcore champion. Haruka and Michiru, your new tag team champions, finally defeating their hated rivals, Tequila Sunrise. Usagi Tsukino defeated Rei Hino to get back into the Senshi and return her Queen of the Mountain briefcase. And then she cashed it in, of course, on the only Vixens Wrestling Federation champion we've ever known, Aerith Gainsborough. And there's a cover, and no count. Well, excuse me, a one count, of course. Yuna and Jill, two very successful competitors in New Gen Wrestling, looking to try and make an impression here tonight and perhaps make their own statement on the title scene. Now that we have new champions in every facet of the Vixens Wrestling Federation, now that we have entirely new champions, one, two, and a near fall there. Now that we have completely new champions, ladies and gentlemen, it's like you wiped the slate clean. It's so wide open now. The victories, they mean so much. And now with new champions, it is literally anybody's ball game here in the Vixens Wrestling Federation. Jill now. Oh, walked into a nice Russian leg sweep from Yuna. Yuna, of course, a former NGW tag team, women's tag team champion, one half of the Gull Wings, who have been reunited here in the Vixens Wrestling Federation. And right now, looking to stake her claim here in the singles division, a win over Jill would be huge. One, two, and another near fall. It's all about making a statement here in the Vixens Wrestling Federation. You have to imagine whoever wins this can easily catch the eye of the VWF Championship Committee, whether it be to get in line for a hardcore title shot or for a chance at the Vixens Wrestling Federation Championship. You have to imagine this match will definitely turn some heads for the winner. And Jill with a couple of knee lifts there. She was once one of the most hated figures in all of CAW back when she was the commissioner of New Gen Wrestling. But of course, after several years of a hiatus, she returned to DCW back in 2009, and the fans welcomed her with open arms. One, two. Did she get her? No. In 2009, she returned to DCW, and the fans were more than willing to welcome her with open arms. And then, 1 year later, she won the second annual Rose Night Diva Invitational, last defeating the previous year's winner, the Diva. And ever since then, Jill Valentine has been she couldn't be more loved by these fans. A very popular figure, especially here in the Vixens Wrestling Federation. Yuna, of course, has been in the title scene a little bit here in the Vixens Wrestling Federation, but hasn't tasted any gold yet, as you see a huge throw into the turnbuckle there, and then a Randy Orton-style backbreaker, hook of the leg, lateral press, one, two, and another near fall. A lot of near falls in this match. Big draw kick from the Stars member, and down goes Yuna. This has been all Jill so far. And Jill now just continuing to go to work. Now she's got a collar and elbow tie up on Yuna. Into a vicious Jake Roberts-style DDT. Oh, my. High impact. That could do it. One. Two. And two is all she can get again. Yuna hanging in there right now, weathering the storm. But Jill trying to press the advantage again. Oh, went for a suplex, but walked into a sunset flip. Schoolboy, one, two. Oh, my, almost got her. And just like that, Yuna gets the advantage right back, and especially right there with that flashback. Now stomping away on Joe. That offensive series really took a lot out of Yuna. And now, oh, my, moonsault off of the ropes did not connect. Now Jill continuing to go to work. Another elbow into the back of Yuna's head. Jill, well-versed in so many different styles of combat as a Stars member. And, oh, huge vicious suplex. Jill even let her hang in the air for an extra couple of seconds to let all that blood rush to the head. And listen to these fans on their feet for Jill Valentine. And a chop block. And now Jill signaling to the fans that it may be time for her patented move, the lockout. She's softening Yuna up. Oh, huge, huge stomps. And now Jill with Yuna wide open, going for the lockout. And no! Yuna scouted that move. She saw it coming. DDT from Yuna. Jill just about turned the lights out. But Yuna obviously did her homework. And now she's going to go for it again. This time she connects. Connects with the lockout. But Yuna's right back up. Unbelievable. And into a backdrop. How did Yuna get right back up from the lockout? A cover. One. And only a one count. And Yuna now really starting to feel it. On the comeback trail, that's for sure. Perching Jill on the top rope. And Tornado DDT coming up, maybe. Oh, the Shatter Sphere level two. And that could do it. One, two, yes, she got her. Yuna withstands the lockout, comes back, hits the Shatter Sphere level two, and takes the Duke over Jill Valentine. Huge win for Yuna here tonight in the opening contest of this week's Nitro. And Yuna just made a huge statement, maybe inching herself, if you will, ever closer, perhaps to a title shot. What does the future hold for one half of the Gold Wings, Yuna? Well, tonight, it holds a victory. Big win over Jill. And I think Queen Usagi's reign of terror is just beginning. Oh, my. And let's take you to the boss. VWF fans, this commentator can't wait to see the former Vixens Wrestling Federation champion Aerith Gainsborough exercise that very rematch clause. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to move on here. And there you see Makoto Kino, a member of the Sailor Senshi. And of course, we saw her just a few moments ago back in the dressing room, getting an absolute verbal dressing down by the woman that she called her teammate, her colleague, her compatriot, her fellow Senshi member, and most importantly, her friend, Queen Usagi, who certainly is not acting like a friend right now to her fellow Senshi. But as it stands, Makoto Kino ready for this big match. And she better be ready, because she is taking on this woman. It was 3 weeks ago on Nitro when the Hillary Duff Express was completely derailed by one half of the new tag team champions, Haruka Tenno. Hillary Duff really looked to make an example out of Haruka, but she was stopped in her tracks. She underestimated the outer Senshi member, and it cost her a victory. But tonight, Hillary Duff, the former CCW Women's Champion, looks to get right back on track, looks to thrust herself right back into the title picture. Can Hillary Duff rebound from that devastating loss 3 weeks ago? Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're about to find out here tonight. And she is in there against a quality competitor. Will Hillary Duff's long list of victims add one more name? We find out right now on this week's edition of Monday Nitro. And these fans on their feet here. As always, another sellout crowd, another 20,000 plus, and they are absolutely rocking inside the VWF arena. Of course, ladies and gentlemen, as always, we are the league that connects to you. You can find us on Facebook and Twitter. On Twitter, use the hashtag VWF Wrestling. Of course, you can go onto our Facebook and get a special sneak preview of the remodeling and the renovations coming to the VWF Arena. The VWF Arena will be getting a new makeover and a brand new attitude for 2012. 2012 looks to be the year of the Vixens Wrestling Federation. And with that being said, Hillary Duff right now with the advantage on Makoto Kino. Of course, Hillary Duff giving up quite a bit of size and quite a bit of height to Makoto Kino. Makoto, probably the most athletic of the Senshi, But Hillary Duff holding her own. She's not intimidated by anybody inside that square circle. That's why she was a former CCW Women's Champion and a former ROW World Heavyweight Champion. Yes, that's right. She held a Men's World Championship. So that shows you she is afraid of no one. Now Hillary Duff, Suplex City coming up, delivers. Lateral press, one, and only a one count. Still a long way to go in this one. Duck under by Hillary Duff. Into an inverted atomic drop and a beauty. She nailed it. Into a headlock. And now perhaps another suplex. Yes, back down to earth she comes. Hillary Duff right now with the momentum on Makoto Kino. Makoto now with a headlock into a huge knee. Oh my, that had to rattle Hillary Duff's teeth. Leapfrog. Hillary Duff off the ropes again. Nice arm drag takedown. Shades of Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. And a huge elbow right into the grill of Hillary Duff. Of course, like I said in our opening contest, every single title division here in the Vixens Wrestling Federation is wide open right now. Anybody can make a name for themselves. As you see, Makoto Kino here doing reps with Hillary Duff. Oh my, did about 10 reps like she was doing reps on the barbells. And that just shows you how much strength and size Hillary Duff is giving up in this one. But she has never backed down from a challenge. And now, oh my, a huge shot to that lower lumbar region. That could do it. One, two, and only a two count. Every single title division here in the Vixens Wrestling Federation is wide open. Spots for number one contenderships are open to the teams and to the individuals that want them the most. And lately, Hillary Duff has really seemed to be one of the hungriest of the VWF Vixens. And tonight, she can really take a positive stride forward and get back on her make a statement tour. And you saw a surfboard stretch right there. What a way to contort your competitor's body. Your opponent's body, I should say. Excuse me. Kononobo tie-up, headlock from Makoto Kino. Irish whip. Hillary Duff sent into the buckle. Makoto Kino gives chase. Big drop kick sends Hillary Duff down. Hillary Duff in a compromised position and another drop kick. And Makoto Kino with the advantage right now. Picking Hillary Duff back up, but a big right hand from Hillary Duff. Kononobo tie-up. Launched her into the turnbuckle, face first. Hillary Duff gives her a running start. Oh, and shoves her right back into the steel post. And now, setting her up for a huge powerbomb. Hillary Duff deceptively strong, never count her out. And now, hook of the leg. One, two. Wow, two and a half, two and three quarters, maybe. Irish whip. Makoto into another turnbuckle and a huge clothesline sends her crumbling down in a heap. Hillary Duff off the ropes, drives the elbow home. Ladies and gentlemen, still plenty of more action to come on our last edition of Nitro for 2011. What a year for the Vixens Wrestling Federation that 2011 has been, and you can rest assured 2012 will indeed be the year of the Vixens Wrestling Federation. Ladies and gentlemen, we are so glad to have your support and your viewership. You have made the Vixens Wrestling Federation what it is today. We would be nothing without you, the fans. And now into a camel clutch here. Makoto Kino just contorting Hillary Duff's back. This one's really been back and forth. And Makoto Kino scores with that splash from the second rope. Now, Makoto going to leap again. Measures her, leaps, scores with a knee drop. That could have very easily broken some of Hillary Duff's ribs. And Makoto Kino now looking to finish this one off. She's going for her trademark MKO. And these fans know it. Does Hillary Duff know it? Hillary Duff is about to be in a world of hurt. No, a punch to the midsection and a big drop kick. And just like that, Hillary Duff gets right back out of trouble. Now launching Makoto over the ropes and sends her flying into that steel guardrail. Hillary Duff leaps and connects. Oh my. Both of these ladies really having to work for this one. But with new champions across the board, that's the name of the game. Do whatever it takes to get yourself in line for a shot at the prestigious Vixens Wrestling Federation Championship. Referee with a 20 count to work with. And Makoto there buried a right hand and a kick into Hillary Duff, but she didn't even move. Now Hillary Duff fired back in on the inside. Makoto gives her an elbow to think about. And a leg drop there nearly took Hillary Duff's head off. And this could do it. Lateral press, but no hook of the leg. Two. And only a two. Not hooking that leg can make a world of difference. Gotta hook that leg and take away your opponent's ability to use their legs to get their forward momentum up and get their shoulders off of the mat. Back drop from Hillary Duff connects. Hillary Duff's been in a lot of trouble in this one. And you can see her, she's favoring those ribs after that huge knee drop off the top. Now Hillary, on the top rope, scores with a missile drop kick. Makoto Kino is just about on Dream Street. Hillary Duff leaps again and scores. What a great match here tonight on the last Nitro of 2011. And now Hillary Duff with a big neck breaker. Makoto Kino just about out into the Lion Tamer. Hillary Duff turns her over. Lion Tamer. Makoto nowhere to go. Hillary Duff yanking back with all her might. But Makoto powers out. Unbelievable strength from Sailor Jupiter Makoto Kino. But Hillary Duff is not deterred. She's once again back on the offensive. But Makoto counters out. But Hillary Duff counters out with a go behind. Big shot to the back of the head. And yes, she sets her up. Unprettier. Unprettier. She planted her. The cover, only a one count. Unbelievable. I have watched Hillary Duff compete since 2004, and I have never seen someone kick out of the unprettier at one. Unreal. How badly do these two women want it? How badly do they want it? And now Hillary Duff scores with a lion salt. It's got to be running through her mind. What is it going to take to put Makoto Kino away for good? What has she got to do? And now, taking her legs back out from under her, she's going to hook another Lion Tamer. Lion Tamer, she hooked it again. Cinching back with all her might. Can Makoto power out again? Does she have it in her? Yes, she powers out again. She powered out again. Unbelievable intestinal fortitude on the part of Makoto Kino. She walked into a small package. One, two, it's over. Hillary Duff put her away with a small package. And Hillary Duff scores a huge victory over Makoto Kino here tonight on Nitro. And the Hillary Duff Express is right back on track, operating at full steam. What a back and forth contest. But give credit to Hillary Duff. She never gave up. Makoto powered out of two Lion Tamers, kicked out of the unprettier. But Hillary Duff, the veteran, caught Makoto in a small package and took the win. And now, of course, ladies and gentlemen, moving on. It was last night at Femme Fatale. As I've stated, we have three new champions here in the Vixens Wrestling Federation. And this was our second title changing hands. It was a brutal TLC match between Tequila Sunrise, the popular champions, and Haruka and Michiru, the Outer Senshi. Of course, Dixie Clements got taken out early in the match. It turns out that she did indeed suffer a concussion, but she still was in there fighting, tried to get to the belts, but got taken out by Hataka. And of course, that left the door wide open for Michiru to claim the belt 15 feet above the ring. And just like that, after five confrontations with their hated rivals, Hataka and Michiru are your new tag team champions, and they're standing by. And it appears the already shaky relationship between the members of Al-Qaeda continues to get even shakier. But of course, ladies and gentlemen, last night it was the number one contendership bout, last woman standing between the living legend Ami Mizuno and the leader of Al-Qaeda, Abdallah Bin Laden. Back and forth match, grueling, but of course, perhaps the most notable point of the match was when Ami had Abdallah down for a 9 count and picked her up just before the official counted to 10. Abdallah did not make the same mistake. She hit the WMD and Ami was down for the count. She became the new number one contender. And of course, last night it was Lufisto's Hardcore Invitational. Lufisto defending her Hardcore title against the returning Danica Patrick, Jessica Simpson, and the Tomb Raider, Lara Croft. And you talk about an intense match to open up Femme Fatale. These four women absolutely went to war. Lufisto looked like she was in very good shape to once again retain her Hardcore title. But after a series of roll-ups and reversals, Lara Croft was able to put Lufisto away for the 3 count, and just like that, she became the new Vixens Wrestling Federation Hardcore Champion. And there you see an amazing sequence there as Lara and Lufisto went back and forth, but in the end, it was Lara Croft who was able to hold Lufisto down for the 3. And of course, the theme for Femme Fatale was performed by Egypt Central, available now wherever music is sold. And ladies and gentlemen, you still have a chance to be a part of Femme Fatale. Make that call to your cable provider for an encore presentation of Femme Fatale. Call your local internet provider for an encore presentation right now. And now, ladies and gentlemen, a rematch from Femme Fatale last night for the Hardcore title. The now ex-champion, Lufisto, challenges the new champion, Lara Croft. Diana Buffer, take it away. And that's what it's all about here tonight. What a contest coming your way, ladies and gentlemen. Always an interesting affair whenever we have a title up for grabs here on Nitro. And there you see the proud new champion, the Tomb Raider Lara Croft. This is her first title here in the Vixens Wrestling Federation. And she earned it in that brutal hardcore invitational at Femme Fatale. And she looks ready, and she better be ready, because, well, she's competing in this woman's kind of match. There you see the former hardcore champion, the ever popular and beloved super hardcore anime Lufisto. And she looks ready for action here tonight on Nitro. Lufisto, a proud fighting champion. In fact, she is still the only woman to ever hold the VWF Hardcore Championship and retain it on multiple occasions. I'm sure that Lufisto feels that that is truly her belt that Lara Croft is wearing, but tonight she's gonna have to work for it, because Lara Croft is as dangerous a competitor as any you will find here in the VWF. There you see what it's all about. Big rematch from Femme Fatale as the super hardcore anime Lufisto tries to take down the new champion Lara Croft. And the crowd sidewise is about 50-50. Lara, a very popular competitor, but then again, so is Lufisto. And Lufisto already going out, throwing some weapons into the ring. Remember, since this is for the VWF Hardcore Championship, there are no rules, no disqualifications, no countouts. It is win by any means necessary. And Lufisto right now taking her time, putting some weapons in the ring, and Lara Croft is not objecting in the least bit. Lara just letting her take her time here. Lufisto getting everything set up. This is actually a good strategy from Lara Croft, because now Lufisto has gone through all the work of digging out these weapons, and Lara Croft now, oh, Lufisto left herself wide open, and Lara took advantage. I don't blame her. Lufisto uncharacteristically left herself wide open. And now Lara on the outside, big Northern Lights suplex, one. And that could have done it already. And Lufisto gets up. She is red hot mad. I'm sure Lufisto was not even able to sleep last night. Lufisto was visibly furious at Femme Fatale after losing what she considers her belt. And listen to this. Oh my goodness. We have lost our minds. Lara Croft just got her brain scrambled. Oh my goodness! That hurt me just to watch it! And already Lufisto is wasting no time. Lufisto came out. This is the angriest I have ever seen her. Oh my, and Lara Croft fired over their steel steps. Maybe there isn't anything that Lara Croft can do. Maybe Lufisto tonight is just, oh my, she's just an absolute tornado. She is a whirlwind in and out of that squared circle. And that is how she earned the name Super Hardcore Anime. And Lara Croft just self-defense, trying to fight back. But Lufisto takes those steel steps away from her. Those are 50 pounds of solid steel. And down goes Lara again. Lufisto looking to put Lara Croft on the shelf for good. And all the Lara Croft fans out there can only sit by and helplessly watch as one of their favorite competitors gets torn apart here. One, two, And maybe by the end of this match, Laura Croft will have wished she'd have just stayed down for the three count, because Lufisto continuing to pour on the punishment. Ladies and gentlemen, have you ever seen Lufisto more motivated and angry in your lives? Oh, my. Lufisto right there tried to leap from the top rope, and Laura Croft ducked out of the way. This is Laura's first chance to actually get back in this match, and that Hurricane Rana will help. That was Laura Croft's first offensive move since that Northern Lights suplex to start the match. Scoop slam. And now the Tomb Raider, Laura Croft, definitely in self-preservation mode. Nails a crossbody. Sometimes that anger can get the best of you. When you hit the ring as angry as Lufisto did, sometimes, yes, of course, it helps to dish out the punishment, and it helps to keep the advantage, but also that blinding anger will leave you wide open to someone who has been in this situation before. And Laura Croft is definitely a seasoned veteran. Back in 2004, she was the only woman in no DTQ CAW history to compete in that league. So she is a true veteran in this sport, and she exploited Lufisto. But Lufisto right back on the offensive. That anger is also a great painkiller. Two, and only a two count. Can Laura Croft just weather the storm here and hope that the super hardcore anime makes a mistake? And now Laura, boot to the midsection. Crossbody connects again. Laura Croft on the top. Scores with a senton splash. And now Lufisto not getting up. That looks to have definitely slowed her down. And now Laura. Oh, my. We've seen this before. Oh, my. Tried to perhaps break Lufisto's leg. But Lufisto got out of it. And that just shows you. Well, wait a minute. Lufisto with Shades of Sabu scores with that moonsault. And that just shows you how badly these two want it. One, two, and only a two count. How badly does Lufisto want her belt back, and how badly does Laura Croft want to keep it? Oh, huge spinning heel kick by Lufisto. And now Laura Croft perched on the top. Frankensteiner! And down goes Laura Croft, and I think she even landed on the table. And Lufisto, looking like perhaps she was just too much for Laura Croft here tonight. Oh, use that chair for some extra leverage on that leg drop. And the super hardcore anime is absolutely rolling here tonight on Nitro. Will Lufisto go into 2012 as your new hardcore champion? And now Laura with the table. Oh, my, tried to hit Lufisto with it, and now setting Lufisto up on the table. Laura Croft can get down and dirty with the best of them. Now Laura Croft, 15 feet above the ring. Lufisto on the table. Laura Croft leaps and misses with a senton splash, and she goes through the table. That'll do it. One, two, and we have a new champion. No, no, the official says no. Only a two count. Boy, that was close. Over the ropes, 360 goes Lufisto. And Laura Croft sends her flying. Laura, determined to try and retain the hardcore title. It's the first gold she has ever had here in the Vixens Wrestling Federation. And now, Laura Croft just pouring that RC Cola all over Lufisto. You have any idea how sticky that stuff is? Now, Laura sends Lufisto back in with an elbow for emphasis. Now Laura back into the ring. Truly yet another brutal hardcore match for the Vixens Wrestling Federation hardcore title. And oh my, Laura just slapped the taste right out of Lufisto's mouth. And now Laura Croft. What's she got in mind here? Oh, my, just swinging and hitting a home run with that ladder on, across Lufistov's head, and then a bulldog. And Laura, the hardcore champion, setting that ladder up on the ropes. Now she's got a chair. What more can these two do to one another? Oh, Van Terminator! And there's no way that Lufistov could get up from that. But Laura Cross not done. Lufistov struggles to her feet. Oh, just another huge swing. And yet another. And what a brutal match this has turned out to be. Lufistov wants the belt bad. Laura Croft wants to keep it. Who wants it more? Oh, Lufistov with a suplex over that ladder. That could have easily broken Laura Croft's back. And now Lufistov going out once again. I don't know if there's anything else these two women can throw at each other. I think they've run out of improvised weapons here. Lufistov. Chop block onto Laura Croft. Remember, this is for the Vixens Wrestling Federation Hardcore title. German suplex and Laura Croft's head snapped back on that ladder. I hope that wasn't bones breaking that I heard, but perhaps that will be. Lufistov once again just using that ladder. And once again, three times, Laura Croft has been German suplexed onto that solid steel ladder. This is getting tough to watch. And you can only hope that Lufistov will finally just decide to put Laura Croft away before Laura Croft's career gets ended right here in an instant. And now Lufistov. It's almost scary how resourceful Lufistov can be with these weapons. And Lufistov right there with that modified downward spiral that used to be used by former CCW Women's Champion Amanda. Laura Croft with a boot to the midsection, though trying to do anything she can to try and retain the hardcore title, but it's too little too late. Lufistov, Emerald Fusion. Lufistov will become a three-time champion. One, two, yes, it's over. Laura Croft, well, give her credit for finally getting her first gold here in the Vixens Wrestling Federation. But that success only lasted 24 hours. Just like that, Lufistov is once again your VWF Hardcore Champion. Laura Croft maybe bit off a little bit more than she could chew after she won the Lufistov Hardcore Invitational last night at Femme Fatale, because that meant that she would have to step in the ring once again with Lufistov in Lufisto's kind of match. This was Lufistov's forte all along, and she just showed you why. It doesn't get much more hardcore than the Super Hardcore Anime. And once again, she is your Vixens Wrestling Federation Hardcore Champion. Lufistov has done it here tonight. You have seen history. You have seen a new champion here on the last Nitro of 2011. Lufistov goes into 2012 as your Hardcore Champion. And what a representative. She deserves it. The Super Hardcore Anime back on top. And the music hits. Usagi Tsukino not getting a chance to boss around this crowd at the VWF Arena. Here comes the former champion. And ladies and gentlemen, Aerith has hate in her eyes. This could be ugly. Let's take you back to the ring. Oh, my, and it is on next week on the first edition of Nitro in 2012. It will be the rematch of a lifetime. Aerith Gainsborough will get her rematch against the woman who stole the Vixens Wrestling Federation Championship from her 24 hours ago. And ladies and gentlemen, I can't wait for that match. I'll be waiting the entire week on pins and needles, and I'm sure you will be too. But now, for Aerith, it's time to focus on the task at hand. It is time for your main event of the evening here on the last Nitro of 2011. Ladies and gentlemen, I cannot emphasize how great a year it's been for the Vixens Wrestling Federation here in 2011, our very first year. But now, the Vixens Wrestling Federation looks to hit its prime in 2012. This will be our last VWF match of 2011, and what a way to send it out, because it is a rematch from the main event of VWF Retribution 2 months ago, and perhaps one of Aerith's biggest title defenses in her entire career. She was able to retain against Lindsay, who was very willing, ready, and able to take the title from her. But of course, Aerith, being the fighting champion she is, you talk about somebody with intestinal fortitude that you can't even measure. She was able to withstand Lindsay, and she was able to retain the title at Retribution. But tonight, it's a whole different story. Now, Aerith coming in without the belt. This will be her first match since losing the Vixens Wrestling Federation title. And now Aerith with a DDT. What a sight it would be if Aerith could put this one away early. Oh my, but Lindsay with a flying tackle. Of course, ladies and gentlemen, the VWF Nation has definitely sent its heart out to Aerith, who was such a fighting champion, who was such a deserving first ever Vixens Wrestling Federation champion. She gave the belt so much prestige. What a great champion. And ladies and gentlemen, just what a heartbreaking way for her title reign to end, like it did last night at Femme Fatale. Just absolutely gut-wrenching and heartbreaking. And wait a minute, Lindsay there trying to use the ropes for leverage, but Aerith kicked out. And tonight, here in the main event of Nitro, it'll be interesting to see how far these two women have come in the last 2 months since Retribution. What have these two learned about each other? How will this match vary from their Retribution classic? Lindsay off the ropes. Big hip toss by Aerith. And the former champion definitely on her A game here tonight. She wants to make a statement by defeating Lindsay. Big DDT once again from the former champion. It's hard for me. I keep having to bite my tongue. One, and only a one count. I keep having to bite my tongue. I keep wanting to say the champion, but of course, ladies and gentlemen, she is the former champion, and it's definitely going to take some getting used to, because, ladies and gentlemen, I'm sure you as well as I absolutely loved seeing this woman's first title reign. I mean, it definitely a title reign for the history books. Aerith fired into the buckle. Lindsay with a big shoulder charge. Aerith in a compromised position, but no, she rolls out of the way. Lindsay, collar and elbow tie-up into a headlock, and a counter, a go-behind from Aerith, and a shot to the back of the neck. A back of the head, and into a spinning heel kick. Aerith, collar and elbow tie-up, Irish whip. Lindsay, over the ropes, 360. Aerith, oh, tried to clothesline her out, but Lindsay pulled the ropes down. And now Aerith is on the outside and in some major trouble. Oh, my, just tossed into that barricade. And now, oh, no. Oh, no, no, Aerith got out of it. Aerith almost got dropped face first into that steel barricade. And now going to give Lindsay a taste of her own medicine. Got it. What's good for the goose is good for the gander. And Lindsay just learned that lesson. And another big Hurricane Rana there from the former champion. Lion Salt connects. Aerith is absolutely a house of fire tonight here on the last edition of Nitro in 2011. Aerith Gainsborough, definitely the leader of the Vixens Wrestling Federation in its tender first year. And now Lindsay once again, oh, come on, referee, give me a break. And once again, thankfully, Aerith is able to kick out. Coronado Taya. Headlock from Lindsay. Into a trap belly-to-belly suplex. And driving the elbow right into the face of Aerith. Aerith Gainsborough will truly, even if she never wins the title again, will be remembered perhaps as one of the greatest champions in the history of the Vixens Wrestling Federation and all of women's CAW wrestling. A truly great representative of this league. Two! And Aerith once again able to kick out. Like I said at the outset, this is a rematch from the main event of the first click-for-view in VWF history, which was Retribution. Aerith Gainsborough came out on top in that one, retaining the Vixens Wrestling Federation Championship. And of course, it really seems like Lindsay has definitely done her homework. She's watched a lot of film on Aerith, and she has learned a lot from their Retribution match, because at Retribution, it was Lindsay coming in. I mean, she tried to come in and let her anger and hatred motivate her, but she made a lot of key mistakes in that match. Aerith was able to capitalize on all of them, use the fans to her advantage, draw energy off of them, weather the storm, and she was able to defeat Lindsay. But Lindsay has obviously learned a lot, because she has been the aggressor for about three-fourths of this contest. Oh my, and a big, well, perhaps a bookend there from Lindsay. And Lindsay, if she could put away the former Vixens Wrestling Federation champion here, would definitely line herself up for a title shot. Five-finger shuffle. And the former NGW Women's Champion looking to put away the former Vixens Wrestling Federation champion. But no, Aerith comes right back with a bookend of her own. Not to be outdone, says the former champ. Hook of the leg. One. Two. Will that do it? No. Referee quick to signal that it was a two count. And Aerith, a nice scoop slam there. Now, Aerith Gainsborough on the top rope. Leaps, scores with a hangover. Listen to this, 20,000 plus. You talk about a renowned figure, a beloved human being, someone that the fans can love and absolutely cherish. You talk about a true treasure here in CAW Wrestling. You're talking about Aerith Gainsborough. These fans absolutely love her, and they want nothing more than to see her defeat Lindsay tonight and go on next week into our inaugural 2012 broadcast, ladies and gentlemen, and get her Vixens Wrestling Federation title back. These fans would love to see her make Queen Usagi eat her words. Aerith got that extra motivation right before Lindsay hit the ring. She got that extra motivation from Queen Usagi. Now, Aerith is determined to send a message to the Vixens Wrestling Federation champion. And right now, she's got the advantage. Oh my, but a small package from Lindsay. One. No, Aerith reversed it. Two. Lindsay reversed it. Two. No. Oh my. What a confrontation here tonight in the main event of Nitro. What a way to end 2011. What a way to end it. This has definitely surpassed Lindsay and Aerith's Retribution match. This has surpassed it in every way. What a back and forth match. Luthes press, fist and fire. Fist and fire. This one has been back and forth so many times. But Aerith with a kip up. Oh, Lindsay was trying to signal for the FUB, but she let her guard down. Kendra twist of fate. That's the move that helped Aerith retain the title against Tifa. One, two, no. No, Lindsay kicked out. I don't believe it. But Lindsay is still in trouble. Aerith not letting up for a single solitary moment. Lindsay's out on her feet. A shot blocked and a big right hand. A second. These two exchanging blows. Lindsay stunned. Wait a minute. That's Usagi. Give me a break. Oh no, not this. Aerith had this match against Lindsay won. Oh no, and a replay from Femme Fatale. Oh dear heavens, Moon Clash. Oh my God, we gotta get some help for Aerith. And Queen Usagi, once again, sneaks up like a thief in the night, once again on Aerith. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, what a horrible way to end this fantastic edition of Nitro. But as it stands, Usagi will not be able to run next week. It'll be the rematch. Good night, God bless, Happy New Year from the VWF.